What's up, YouTube? In this video, I'm going to show you guys my trades of the week. I'm going to show you four winners and two losers. Stay tuned. Okay, guys, so my first winner here earlier on in the week was TTWO. Okay, they had a huge drop off here off, if you're looking on my right side of my screen, my 10 minute. They bought out Zynga, so they had a huge drop-off, which I didn't think it would go that low, but it did. So I have waited. There was a nice support here, and as you can see, we had a support here turned into resistance, and then after hours, it had broke. This is on Monday, and then coming into Tuesday, I was looking for the break of this 142.75 area, and we did get it nice and clean. As you could see here on the 3 minutes, we had a nice clean breakout. So I got in on that third candle with calls, sold one here, waited for the pullback. I wish I had sold a little more. We got in back at that area. Remember, resistance tends to turn into support. So we did get it to act as support here. We got the bounce on the 10-minute chart here. And then we rode the 8 to 21 EMA cloud the whole way up. And I sold most of them at the first high, the high of the day there, just under 148. Most of them I sold right in this area here. And then we did break, and I only kept one. And I ended up selling it right when we opened, right in here. Obviously, wish I had held a little longer for that, but we still made a good amount of money with that call as well. Okay, so that was one of my better trades of the week. Let's look at another one with Ford. Okay, guys, so I have Ford pulled up here again on Webull. So as you can see on the right here, I have the 1 hour time frame. Then the left, I have the three, which is what I use for most of my day trading, is the 3 minute, the 10 minute, and the 1 hour. So as you can see, I was using the 25 area in red here as our main resistance. Couldn't break, almost came up. And then we finally got that breakout. Okay, so let's take a look there at our 3 minute chart on the left here. Okay, so this is Thursday, 3 minute time frame, Thursday, 10 minute time frame. Again, here we had that nice clean break at 25. I like to get in on the third candle after two green candles close with the second one higher. So this one was a higher close than the first candle. We got the break. I'm in with calls. Immediately we went red, but I actually ended up buying more. Okay, so that old resistance tend to turn into support, right? So I got more and to back myself up with even more conviction. It was just about to hit that EMA cloud, and that tends to push, since it's a bullish cloud, even higher. Okay, this should be green. Sometimes the program glitches and it goes to red. This cloud should be green, but it's a bullish cloud going up. Okay, so we got even more here, and then we rode the whole way up, and I sold most of them in this area. Sold one here. I held one for a bigger move. Didn't get it. I cut it. I think it was like actually down here at the bottom for just a small little gain. But that was a great trade using that old resistance line, that $25 area as a resistance turned into support again here. Okay. That's why I drew it out. Resistance turned to support. We had a nice winning trade. Let's take a look at Roku. Okay, guys, so here with Roku, again, I have the 1 hour pulled up here, and then I have a smaller time frame, 3 minute time frame here on the left. Okay, so as you can see here with Roku, I have a bunch of lines drawn out. Pay attention, though, to that 190 area with that nice red line there. Okay, so we had support. We had the breakdown last week, and then we have that going to be resistance now. Okay, support turns to resistance turned into support, and I'm going to take advantage of that, but on a lower time frame. Remember, we're going to be going short at that 190 area. Again, here a few days ago on Wednesday, we did. We took the puts. Shorting means you're either buying puts or you're shorting the common shares, for those who don't know what that means. So I'm hoping the stock goes down for at least a short amount of time so I can profit off of it. If it doesn't, I would lose on the trade and accept my stop loss. But in this case here, we did that support right here that we had prior to that touch and that touch. That's our key level. That's where we're shorting off of. This right here where I'm circling is this huge area right here. Okay. So we got those puts right at open. I was looking for this to go all the way down, and we did. This was a big winner for us this week. So if we look on the 10-minute time frame, as you can see, this thing had bearish clouds the whole entire day. Okay, I didn't get in on the whole move. So we got in short here just above or just under 190. It's like 188.50, 189. I bought in a few different times. I only had three or four, but I sold two right away for a nice gain. And then I held a few more. I sold one here and I sold like one immediately after. Yeah, I think it was this candle and then partway down this candle. So again, that's a $10 difference between the last put I sold and from where I bought it at. So that was another big winner there with Roku. Could have rode it all the way back down. As you can see, the 10-minute cloud was bearish. Okay, so that 8 to 21 EMA was bearish, and so was the 34 to 50 EMA cloud, this yellow one, which it touched and it slammed all the way back down. So you could have got even more, which I didn't, but I got the first wave down. I'll take it, and we'll go on to the next trade. So let's take a look at our last play with Microsoft. That was our another big winner. Okay, guys, so here's Microsoft. Again, I have the 1 hour here on the right, 3 minute smaller time frame with Microsoft on the left. Okay, so the day I made this trade was yesterday, Thursday. When you're trading a big, large cap like Microsoft or Apple, Tesla, Walmart, stuff like that, you want to watch the SPY or an index like that, that it's in, because if it's going down, the stock that you're trading is most likely to go down too. Okay. So with Microsoft, as you can see, we had this nice support area, this big green line here I have drawn out, bounced off that. And as you can see here, as I'm zooming in, we broke underneath and kind of just couldn't break it. Look at all these touches. We had a little false breakouts here, not true breakouts. Again, we finally broke it and became support. Okay. So let's take a look over at our 3 minute candles there on the left. So this green line here, I was looking for the breakdown, and then I was going to go short underneath. This could have easily come back, and I probably would have missed it. I definitely would have missed it because I was looking to go short. And let's see how the trade went. Okay. So again, another pretty clean break here. We had first green candle, second green candle didn't close underneath, but the third one did even more. So I got in right there on that fourth red candle. Again, this could have easily went back up. Now it would have been stopped out, but we got that nice clean break to the downside. Okay. If this would have came back up, guys, you don't want to just keep adding to your position, holding. That's going to come back. Just take your 10, 30% loss. It's not a lot when you're trading options, and move on to the next trade. Even if it comes back down, you don't want to keep FOMO into buying the same one, thinking, oh, I had it, but I didn't wait. Okay, you're not going to make it if you ever do that. So we got the clean break, and as you can see on the 10, again, this green cloud, the 8 to 21 EMA cloud, that's supposed to be red. Okay, there's a little glitch in the program, but I know that this is bearish. Okay, so the whole way down, it was touching, not even touching this and going down the whole day. This was a super bearish day for the market. I didn't hold for all the way down there. Okay, I was getting out way up in here. Probably sold a little too early. There's no reason for me to get out. The cloud stayed bearish, but again, I dumped most of them right in here. We didn't even get that second leg down. I was already out. Kind of regretted it. This could have been, you know, $5,000 to $10,000 profit. Didn't get that, but I still got a good win on this. And with only three puts I had, so you know, I'm gonna take it, and we'll move on to the next trade. That's something I need to work on, is holding a few a little longer when my winners are big there. So let's take a look at a few losers this week. All right, guys, so I have SE here. Another play I was looking to short on. A lot of plays were short this week, unfortunately. And I'm more of a guy who likes to go long, but sometimes you got to play to the short side with buying puts instead of buying calls. So on the right side here, the 1 hour time frame, zoom back a little bit in the chart, looking for some key levels. So you can draw them out. I'll draw a few as we're going through. Okay. Support, support, resistance. Okay, so we have this support here acting big, looking for that to become a resistance. So this red line there around that 203, 203.50 area. Okay, Monday we opened up really low. We bounced back. I got the alert this was coming up. So let's see what happens. So right here is basically just a zoomed in version of right here. Okay, on the 12th, a few days ago on Wednesday. So I was looking to go short and we had the pre-market a little above. I wasn't worried about that. But I got in with calls the second the market opened, right there around that 204 area. Stock snapped up and I kind of panic sold. I got out immediately. And guess what happens right after? We got a huge 7-point move to the downside. Didn't even get one to print for me. Lost on all of them. I think I had 4 or 5, but just took the stop a little too quick. I had the right idea. Just didn't execute right. And then again, I saw it come up here again. I was done with the stock, that certain stock for the day. Could have printed again. And then, geez, the next day you would have really printed if you had gotten on these on that move there. Geez, that would have been nuts. But that was a loss, a couple $100. So actually several $100 there. So another loss I had was with DWAC. Let's take a look at that. All right, guys, so I have DWAC here, the Trump stock with Trust Social here. So on the 1 hour time frame here on the right, you can see we have that 65 area resistance. We finally broke here on Wednesday the 12th. So let's take a look at what I was looking at. I was looking to get the breakout and ride the wave up. It happened, but it was a little choppy, and we'll show you what happened with my trade. Okay, so there's that 65 resistance. Again, I look for those two candles that close higher and higher. I don't like to see those wicks coming down. I like to see the candle close with not much wick on the top. But again, followed my rule. I got that second candle to close higher than the first one. So it's a breakout from in my eyes. I bought right up in here the second that third candle started. Immediately dropped down. I held because that's that support line we're looking for. And we got the pop. Didn't sell any. I was looking for a bigger move. So let's look at the 10-minute time frame here. So as you can see, that red, again, it's supposed to be green. It is a bullish trend on the EMA cloud. So we did get that breakdown. And for a breakdown, I look for two candles to close underneath that support. And then it's a breakdown, right? So we had the first candle close below, second candle that was red again, close below. So it's a breakdown in my eyes. I got out, okay? Unfortunately, the second I got out, yes, the 200 moving average there, but I played my rules. It was a false breakout. I'm done with the stock. It did run back up. And as you can see on the 10, we had a huge wave up. I should have stayed in it because as you can see, the red, which should be green, EMA cloud, that 8 to 21 EMA cloud, which I'll make a video how to put that on your charts. Stayed bullish the whole way. Okay, it even dipped down. I mean, yes, it did touch the 34 to 50, but it never closed, or I should say the EMA cloud stayed bullish, never turned and flipped green, which it should be green flipping red. There's a little glitch in the program, but it stayed bullish the whole way. Should have held in there. If anything, just sold a few and rode out the wave because we took that wave up. Unfortunately, I didn't get any of the profits on that. It was a loss, but I had the right idea again. Just kind of a little tight with my losses there. I like to keep them tight, and I did. But again, that could have been a huge, huge win for me. But that's good. That's pretty much how the week went. Some of the breakouts were real clean. I banked on them. Some of them were kind of choppy, like in this situational breakout. I like to use a 3-minute. Some people use a 2. If you're really good, use the 1. But those are the trades of the week, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. My name is Eric. I'm Kid Stock. See you guys all in the next one. Peace.